Assalamualaikum, dear students of class second year. You know, we are studying the chapter alcohol, phenol and the ether, and I have completed the part of alcohol. Now I am going forward towards the phenol. Now, first question is that what is basically a phenol? Introduction of the phenol. Phenol comes from phenyl group. It means if the hydroxyl group, you know, in the alcohol you have read OH group is attached to aliphatic carbon, methyl, ethyl and other aliphatic carbons. If the OH group attached to any benzene ring, you can say if hydroxyl group or OH group, instead of attaching with the aliphatic carbon, attached with the benzene ring directly, then the name called is the phenol. Phenol are basically the aromatic compounds. It contains the hydroxyl group which is directly attached to the benzene ring carbon. Is called as the phenol. Simply, phenol is called as the more than OH may be present, but the simplest phenol is when the single OH is present. Simplest phenol is called as the carbolic acid. So the term phenol comes from the phenyl C6H5. Comes from the phenyl. Phenyl is the old name of the benzene. You know, benzene is the new name, but sometimes when we are studying the nomenclature of the benzene, we are using this word phenyl. So phenyl, phenol come from the phenol. Next is, what is the basically structure of the phenol? You know, very simplest structure of the phenol. Phenol and the alcohols are totally changed to each other. Alcoholic functional group, just like the oxygen atom is basically attached to that carbon of the benzene ring. Each, you already studied the chapter of the benzene ring, each carbon of the benzene ring is sp2 hybridized, and the one of the carbon which is sp2 hybridized is directly attached to the oxygen atom of the OH group. One thing that is different. Second, OH group is also polarized and CO group is also polarized. In the alcohol, there is no conjugation, right? But in the phenol shows the conjugation because it contains the oxygen unshared pair of electron which moves in the benzene ring. That all the conjugation, that terms about the benzene ring, one which I have called sp2 hybridized, second conjugation, third orthopara director, or all of these terms we have studied in a chapter of the benzene ring, so it's not a new thing for you. So this is the just like a any compound that contains the benzene ring is called as the aromatic compound. So phenols are the aromatic compounds. But if you want to see the structure of the phenol, then you are going to understand each carbon is sp2 hybridized, CO bond, OH bonds are polarized. So that is totally different from the alcohol where there is no conjugation, but in the phenol there is the conjugation. Next, how do you prepare the phenol? Phenol can also be phenol can be prepared from the any substituted benzene, right? Substituted benzene means one of the hydrogen is replaced by any group. Here we are using the chlorobenzene. You can use the SO3A sulfonic group. So substituted benzene substituted is used for the preparation of the phenol, that is called as the chlorobenzene. Look at this, that is the chlorobenzene. You can say substituted benzene because here one of the hydrogen of benzene is replaced by the chlorine. You have studied this also. Where did you study this chlorobenzene? You know, in the chapter of the benzene, when you are doing the electrophilic substitution reaction, the electrophilic substitution reaction of the chlorine, right, halogenation, that is the chlorobenzene is formed. So this chlorobenzene is used for the preparation of the phenol. How do you prepare? When it reacts with the 10% sodium hydroxide, what happened? This chlorobenzene is replaced by the sodium phenoxidine, right? Sodium phenoxidine that is easily converted into the phenol in the presence of HCl. This very easily hydrogen is replaced here and HCl is formed. Salt, you can say salt is formed with the phenol. So first thing in the preparation of phenol is very important, that you can consider any substituted benzene, but when you are going to react it with the sodium hydroxide, it always gives you the phenoxidine. So it will become very easy to convert this sodium phenoxidine in the presence of acid to the phenol. Next, another example of this which I am saying. For example, this is another benzene, sodium benzene sulfonic acid, sodium benzene sulfonic acid that you studied, that also you studied in the benzene ring, sulfonation, electrophilic substitution reaction, the term is the sulfonation. So after the sulfonation, you have prepared this benzene sulfonic group. Here is again, you are going to react it with the sodium hydroxide. What is going to be formed? That is called as the sodium phenoxidine. When you have to further react it with the acid, easily converted into the phenol. So if you are using any substituted benzene, chlorobenzene, benzene sulfonic acid, so you have to react it with the sodium hydroxide to form the sodium phenoxidine, right? In the presence of acid, which is converted into the phenol. Now another very important term is the acidic behavior of the phenol. Question arises, what is the acid? Acid are the compounds which are the proton donors, which gives the hydrogen ion. You know, carboxylic acids, in the chapter alkene alkynes, acidic behavior of alkyne, you have studied why the alkyne shows the acidic behavior. Here the question is, why the phenol is more acidic and shows the acidic behavior, and more acidic than the alcohols. Alcohols are also acidic, they show the properties of acid, but here phenol is more acidic than alcohol. How do you define it? For example, if you are going to compare the acidity of phenols and alcohols, then what will you do? Very simple. Relative acidity order of some common compounds. For example, number one is carboxylic acids are the strongest acid. After the carboxylic acid, H2CO3 comes. After the you can say, if you are going to study the organic compound, the most acidic is carboxylic acid, then phenol, then water, and at the end is alcohol. That is the order. Carboxylic acid is stronger than H2CO3, H2CO3 is stronger than phenol, phenol is stronger. Then you can see phenol comes after the carboxylic acid in their acidic behavior. Why? Now the question arises, why the phenol is more acidic than the alcohol? Both contains the hydroxyl group and both contains the oxygen, which has the two unshared pair of electrons. The problem is solved. Look at this. When it releases easily proton, it donates easily proton. Why? Because after giving the proton, this form is oxygen carrying the negative charge is formed, that is called as a phenoxidine, phenoxidine is more stable. How is it stable? Look at this. This negative charge is going to be shifted or moved in the benzene ring and increase the electron density of the benzene ring. How is it explained? For example, this electron is shifted to this side and this electron comes at the ortho position. In the next resonating structure, negative charge of this ortho position comes to this and this negative come on the para position. Again, this come, if you have this negative come go to was the next negative charge. In other words, you can say it shows the conjugation. It shows the conjugation and the negative charge of oxygen atom can be involved with the pi electron cloud of the benzene ring. Negative charge is delocalized. In other words, in the benzene chapter, I have detailed explanation of the conjugation. Now I'm going to give you a revision. What is the, when the negative charge of the oxygen is delocalized in the benzene ring, increases the electron density in at the ortho para position. And second, the very important ion, phenoxide ion becomes the stabilized. Why is it becomes stabilized? Because this delocalization of this negative charge in the benzene ring increases the number of contributing structure. If there is a more number of contributing structure, the compound is more stable. So you can say, so after the proton, it easily and it gives the proton because it forms a phenoxide ion, and phenoxide ion is stabilized itself by giving the five contributing structures. So it is more stable, and the negative charge of oxygen is you can say the negative charge of oxygen is delocalized in the benzene ring, resulting the production of the contributing structure. These resonating structures are very important that make the phenoxide ion more stable, and that's the reason its phenol is stable, more acidic than the alcohol. In the case of alcohol, aliphatic carbon is present. In the aliphatic carbon, there is no resonance, but in the phenyl group, benzene ring, there is a resonance, there is a delocalization of negative charge. As a result of this delocalization, that makes this phenol more acidic. This question is very important and always in the exam. So, what is the question? Why the phenol shows the acidic behavior? Very simple answer. It forms the phenoxide ion, which stabilizes itself by the resonating structures due to the negative charge of oxygen becomes delocalized in the benzene. This is the answer. Now, come to the next point, that is the reactions of the phenol. Phenol shows two types of the reactions. Here is this, if you look at the structure of the phenol, two types of reactions are possible. One reaction that is due to the OH group. Another reactions in which the benzene ring itself is involved. Right? So, number one, I have told you in the chapter of SN1S and 2 reaction, nucleophilic substitution reaction, one nucleophile is substituted with the other nucleophile. Is it possible in the phenol? OH group is replaced with any other nucleophile? No, it's not easy, because here OH group is attached to the benzene ring. On the other hand, electrophilic attack on the ring of the benzene is possible and easy. So phenol are less reactive towards the nucleophiles. Nucleophilic attack is less favored because OH is not easily substituted, not easily replaced, while the electrophilic attack on the benzene ring is possible, which you have seen in the chapter of benzene electrophilic substitution reaction. So in my next lecture, I will tell you these both type of the reactions, the reactions due to the OH group and reaction due to the benzene ring. Thank you so much.